All right, welcome back everybody. Aesop Grimm here, and this is the continuation of our Subnautica Below Zero Chronicle. I need to get my timer going. And there it is. Okay. So, in this episode, we're going to go after some of these artifacts. A third one popped up. Off screen, I did some things I'm going to show you. Not a lot. A fourth one, excuse me. And while I was doing the little bit of what I was doing, I mean, most of it was getting food and water and stuff, Alan chimed in and said that he had found another artifact. So we have four to go check out. But I did a little bit of moving around because I added some stuff. Okay, our jukebox is now in here. And I went ahead and added a speaker into this room. And I built this recycler thing. This is something that you can put a titanium ingot into. And if I understand how it works, it'll break it down to the 10 pieces of titanium again. So that's helpful. How do I get out of this tab? Did I put anything else in here? Let's see. Did I move something up here? No. Okay, I played around with where to put that jukebox a few different ways, and so that's why I'm a little bit uncertain. I think that's everything I've done in here. We can see the progress of our plants. Is that full? Well, I don't want to grow more marble because this is clearly the best. We're probably going to go with this one exclusively. I'll kind of tear everything else up, or maybe I'll make them decorations. You know, something to that effect. I believe I fed the biotank some more. Yeah. Other than that, I think that's it, guys. So, let's go ahead and go. Let's go get the sea truck. And then we'll head off and look at the artifacts. I thought about putting up some potted plants and wallflowers and stuff, but I haven't found, that'll all come later, I guess. All right, so, well, first of all, oh, whoops.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
My bad. go through that process all over again. Okay, now, do I have water in here? No. All right, well, let me go get some water, because I did take care of that off screen, so we should have plenty to grab. Okay, let's also grab a couple safety kits, and we'll grab a couple flares. Okay, so water, not quartz. There we go. All right, safety. Kind of feel like one of these should maybe be labeled safety. There we go. I'll keep that in there. Probably should keep one of these on me. Put these in there. And maybe we'll put overflow water and food. Okay, how are we looking at everything else? Are there things that I need to store? Yeah. Okay. Well, my bad. I could have done this off screen. I just kind of forgot about it. I had to mute mic to cough. I'm sorry. How are we looking on precious metals? This is one of the new tracks we got. Oh, is that gold? It sure is. We're starting to get to the point where we have just lockers. Instead of like lockers full of one item, we have lockers full of one item. Did I say the same thing? Instead of having lockers full of multiple items, we have lockers dedicated to one thing. Lead. What is that sound? That was weird. Okay. Now we can go. Clear? Yes, clear. Okay, seven. Seven is closest. Golly, man. Are these things getting closer to my base? Down a little bit. Might find precious metals in here. Oh, ion. Is this
artifact could provide useful information. Processing. I can visualize a location where we may find an important component for my body. The image is hazy, but I am sure it is correct. A stark surface landscape, dangerously cold. Curved spires stretch to the sky.
Colorful spires? Curved spires stretch to the sky. Stark landscape, very cold. Scans indicate that this array of alien hardware serves to accumulate and quickly release megajoules of energy and is charged by ion cubes stored within. These supercapacitors may be used to smooth transient power events on the conduits connecting various architect sites. Yeah. Capacitors store energy. That's how they work. They store power. And so I think what this is saying is that these are acting as capacitors, so they have stored energy, and therefore the circuits are conducted in a way where if they detect fluctuations in power, then the capacitor takes over for a minute and supplies the power in order to keep everything at a steady current until the fluctuation bypasses, and then the cap stops discharging and is recharged from there, whatever it spent. And that's how it keeps, it's like a bridge rectifier network or something. That's how it keeps the current smooth. Okay, this satellite bears the clear markings of the architect's civilization. It appears to have crash landed, though its structural integrity remains surprisingly intact. The satellite's internal design indicates that it was likely used for long-range data transmission. The data transmission node in the storage housing has long been corrupted by exposure to the elements. What else do we have in here? Magnetite, essential for advanced fab. Magnetite, iron oxide, valued for its magnetic potential amongst other qualities, is used in many Federation technologies, including sonar and torpedo systems. Torpedo for guidance. Carnivores, the brute shark. Titan hole fish migrates more or less at random, feeding from nutrients deposited by the symbiotes. Symbiotes, I think. Exploitable Chinese potato plant, edible. Preston's plant, also edible. Preston's plant consists of semi-translucent leaves and a sweet-fruiting berry. It is handy and capable of growing in even the harshest of climates. The fruit contains a paralytic agent that humans are unable to properly metabolize, but for certain animals, it can act as something of a mild sedative. Well, I ate one, and it didn't affect me. It didn't make me freeze up or anything. Because Marguerite, gave us one. Her name's Marguerite, right? Anyway, interior grow bed, yep. Okay, so we're good on that. Let's see if there's anything else in here that we need to check out. Wow, we got this teal blue, is that right? Is it teal? Crystal. Ice. This actually kind of makes me think of Superman's ship with the ice crystals, and the panels would come up, stuff like that. All right, Robin, it looks like we're done in here. Let's get back out to the sea track and see truck. These replenish H2O. And get you on to the next artifact, which will be that one.
How do humans cope with the loss of memories?
Like forgetting someone's birthday? I don't know.
Terrible at birthdays.
No, important memories. When you die, some quantity of knowledge is lost forever to the next generation. Isn't that...
I'm warning you. If you call humanity inefficient one more time, I will swim us both into the mouth of the Leviathan.
Get him, girl.
I am still having trouble differentiating.
How inefficient?
Efficiency aside, does the loss of knowledge not create complications?
Well, it can be sad. On a personal level, losing someone can be traumatic. But it's harder to process the idea of generational knowledge. Humans aren't networked, so we can't even be aware of what we're losing moment by moment. But we do have written and oral histories.
History is interpreted, and memories are not perfect.
This is true, but it's what we have. We try to learn from history, some of us more than others. Memory is complex. Maybe it's not ideal, but it's what we have.
What happens when you no longer have the memories of others to combine with your own?
You make your own memories and interpretations. You have to experience life as an autonomous being. Discover yourself.
That idea is foreign to me. I hope as we continue to discover these artifacts, my connection will get stronger.
They have the most fascinating interaction. It's a great tool for interesting dialogue. And they're both voices, both voices are well acted. The male voice makes me think of that Marvel superhero that was like created. He's, I can't remember what his name is. But he's not human. You know, he's kind of robot-like. It's been a while since I've watched the Marvel movies. I kind of got tired of them. I don't know. I don't know what it is. That's a series that's been around for a really long time. It's one of the longest running movie series ever.
Warning. Maximum depth reached.
Uh-oh.
Hull damage imminent.
Oh, that is the biggest jellyfish I've ever seen. Better get up here. There we go. Okay, well, let's repair. And, go exploring, I guess. Okay. It's kind of a gorgeous sight. Look at the detail here. This design is... I love this design. I don't suppose we can pass through this coating. Vent garden. What is a vent garden? We're about to find out. The vent garden is a stationary leviathan that anchors itself above thermal vents and houses aquatic flora inside its bell-shaped interior. anchoring tentacles. Six tentacles anchor the vent garden to the seafloor around vents. Each tentacle is capped by a set of thick curved hooks that grow downwards, keeping the vent garden firmly in place. Transparent bell. The hollow bell of the vent garden has a narrow opening. We better head back. Hold on. Can I get in here? No.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Okay, transparent bell. The hollow bell of the vent garden has a narrow opening large enough to accommodate human entry. Okay. The vent garden feeds on thermophilic bacteria and other microorganisms that spew from the vent below. The top of the bell also has an opening that continuously releases water to maintain a consistent internal pressure. Okay. Symbiotic relationship. The bell houses six branching platforms that resemble coral. These platforms contain aquatic flora that remains safe from foraging herbivorous fish. In turn, the flora absorb and synthesize some of the heavy metals and gases emitted by the vents below. Assessment. Docile, nutrient-rich harbors flora. Let's go learn more. Okay, there's the upper vent. Pretty majestic looking. Okay, that's what we're aiming for, but I want to go explore this vent garden first. Okay, there's the vent.
In mineral-rich fissure below.
Okay, there's the ceiling. Here's our platforms. There's nothing to scan in here, it seems. Oh. Spiral plant. Hey, we need this stuff. How do I get it? Okay.
New blueprint synthesized.
54 seconds left. We better go. Oh, I wish I had something in my inventory that would give us a burst of oxygen.
Warning, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh, you know what I need to do is make that ultra capacity tank. I think I'm able to now. I forgot about that. Yeah, I probably should have taken care of that offline.
Oxygen.
Okay, let's go see if we can get this artifact. I don't want to take any chances with oxygen. I want to go as fast as I can. Is there anything else I need to be scanning? Tree spire. Tornado plates. These are the anchors. Reaper's wine glass. I feel stuck. Okay. 93 seconds left. Rubies and something else. Uranite crystal. Clicky. Clicky, clicky, clicky. 75 seconds remaining.
With this artifact, I am again able to trace the imprint of my people. They survived for a time, but then their presence becomes faint.
New technology acquired.
New Techno Ion battery. Okay. 45 seconds left. Did I judge this right? Seconds.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Well, either way, I mean, I could hit my orange floaty thing and probably be to the surface in time, but I think I can make it to the sea truck. Oh, we're cutting it really oxygen. Close. Once again, my instincts were amazing. I knew just, I had a good feel for how much time I had left. I will eat these, I guess. Okay, I got the water out of it that I wanted. Well, cool. Okay, there's 344 left. Oh, we're close to this.
Warning, maximum depth reached.
I'm sorry, sea truck. I didn't mean to hurt you. I forgot. Yeah, forgetting. That reminded me about the birthday thing that they were talking about, like forgetting birthdays. And I said I was really bad at remembering birthdays. It's only happened once in my life, but I literally once that I can remember. But I literally forgot that it was my birthday. And I didn't know how old I was. I had, do the math. I'm oblivious. you know? Birthdays, I'm one of those people that birthdays, not important. Not important. Not to me, or... And so I don't tend to remember other people's birthdays.
Of an astronautical Sol Transkov vessel nearby. Vessel name, Mercury 2.
Okay. Oh, this is the main section. This is the bow section. I need to put a beacon out here. I was going to finish up with... I tend to not remember other people's birthdays also until the point that I realize... It's actually important to them. Is there are people out there that are the opposite of me. A birthday is really important. It has to do with validation of them as a human being and stuff, and being valuable. And so at that point in time, if I can tie it to this is important for this person's well-being, emotionally, psychologically, whatever, then I won't forget it. But just in general. I'm not going to do it naturally. Whoops. Edit beacon name. That's what I want. Okay, this is Mercury 2 bow section. Okay. So this, I believe, is where we find the water filtration device. But at a minute 18, I think we're going to go ahead and... Well, what I want to do, guys... Oh, you know what? I want that titanium. Titanium's been a little bit difficult to get in this game.
New blueprint synthesized.
Okay, that's good. With 48 seconds left, we're gonna make the trek back to the base. That's where I'm gonna save it and end the episode, because I want to look at what I need to make the
Robin, I have found the location of another artifact.
Good. I really hope this one tells us something we need.
As do I.
Signal location uploaded to PDA.
Oh, that's big. Yeah, I want to make the high capacity O2 tank, or whatever it's called. And then come back out to Mercury, too. Oh man, we're being chased. I know we are. Oh! No, 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 no. Get away from me. I should have shocked him. I didn't think to shock him. So he's very fast. Have to get around this island. Get through the patrol zone. We're at 65% health. Got another one to the right. Fire afterburners. Home safe. Oh, he's aggressive now. Oh, well, he might not be to Robin. Maybe he's aggressive to the sea truck.
Welcome aboard, Captain. Okay.
Sea truck modules appear to be okay. Where's our shark at? Need to find out if he's aggressive towards Robin. Maybe he's fully matured. No. He's okay with Robin. Robin is mama. Okay. We need 4 lithium. Ultra high capacity tank. Let's make it now before ending the episode. I just need to go to heavy metals. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, and, hold on, guys. We're gonna have to... Okay, we can make an ion battery now. Okay. Save it. I want to test something. Okay. First, we'll make the high capacity, the ultra high capacity O2 tank. There we go. And then I want to see if this does what I think it does. Too many items. I do not have too many items. Oh, okay. Well, I don't know what that meant, but I remember it does not take 10 titanium anymore. It takes 5, so it gave me all 5 back. Yeah, it takes 5 titanium to make a titanium ingot. So it did deconstruct them. So I understood that correctly. Go back over here to precious metals. Drop the rubies, and I guess ultranite crystal, I think, is organic. Put the ion over here. And we also have spiral plants now, which I can use to make something. Okay, well, I'm gonna hit save again. We're already over time, well over time, probably at 40 minutes. And I'll call it an episode right here. Again, I'm Aesop Grimm. Thank you for coming by the channel. If you like what you saw or you want to help the channel out, give a like or a comment and or a comment. And I will see you in the next episode where this story continues. Thanks for visiting Aesop Grimm's Chronicles. If you've made it this far in the video, please consider rating, commenting, subscribing, and sharing. I hope to see you in the next episode. And until then, stay shiny.